He bred roots, glory to God, knowing that my Jesus, my Yeshua HaMashiach, which means my Messiah himself, was Jewish.
Thank you, Lord.
There's so much more to learn about him.
Thank you, Jesus.
There's so much more to learn about God. I have been saying this word for some time now, a couple of years, and I've been really feeling it. But there's a great transition. Mm-hmm. That the church is about to go through before the coming of the Lord. Amen. I'm getting to see that in that great transition, there's going to be a lot of erroneous things uncovered. A lot of things that was just not God's way, but yet it was man's way. Men that were not inspired by God. All the way down to the mere word Easter and what it means. And I'm going to bring a teaching to you guys, and I'm going to show you what that word Easter means. And it has nothing to do with Christ.
Amen.
We need to move that word out of our vocabulary.
Amen.
Easter is what the world does with the bunny rabbits and the Easter eggs and the baskets and the candy. None of that has nothing to do with our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
But we will go over teachings to bring you into the knowledge of what God is saying. We are the church at large, the body of Christ is in for a great transition, a huge shift.
Amen.
It's going to cause us to be willing to move from where we are to where he is. Some are not going to be willing to go. And some are ready, like Mary was. Whatever you say, God, I will do it. If we think we've maxed out God, we are sadly mistaken. We will never max him out. We will never plateau out on God. But there are some things he wants us to know. Amen?
Amen?
And we will come to know them as we submit ourselves to learn about him.
Amen.
He said, take my way and learn. Jesus was from the beginning. And so is he now.
Amen.
Glory to God. I'm just, as I say, full. Glory to God. And I'm just excited too. I'm full and I'm excited.
Hallelujah.
And I'm homesick for heaven. I really am. The more I learn, the more. Come on, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It's so awesome. From my Monday night teaching, talking about the new truth. It's just so much. But these tears, the tears of joy. Yet they're tears of sorrow. Because as Jesus said, some of you are not just going to quite get this. But I know that we have to trust God in all things. Knowing that if he brought us this far, he is able to keep us and to take us home where we belong.
Amen.
But you need to know that. I know that. You need to know that personally, amen. At this time, a very old prophetess will come before us, garments of praise. Let's receive her as she comes.
Thank you.
know he's holy, glory to God. He's holy, hallelujah. He said to us, be ye holy, for I am holy, glory to God. Holy Lord God Almighty. He is set apart from all other beings, entity, gods, worlds, things, materialism. I don't care what it is, all the riches in your earth. He's set apart. He's holy. He's set upon his own pinnacle, glory to God. He is sovereign, glory to God. Holy Lord God Almighty, the earth is filled with his glory. Hallelujah! Holy Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah! You are holy. Hallelujah. Fill us with your rule.
Hallelujah, seated with Christ in the heavenly places.
happy to know that we can have a heavenly experience while still being in our earth realm. My God. Hallelujah. It's because we are connected to God. We are in Christ. We are in Him. He's in us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Every day is resurrection. Glory to God. Every day we wake up, we arise, we are resurrected. Glory to God from yesterday's trouble and catapulted into the newness of God. He said, behold, all things are new. How many know it can be new every day? Hallelujah. I forgot about what happened yesterday, but today it's fresh, it's new. Hallelujah. His mercy and grace is made new for me every morning. Glory to God. No longer the stain of yesterday is upon me. Why? Because I understand who I am in God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. There's only one word to describe my Messiah, my Yeshua HaMashiach is holy. And because He's holy, I am holy. Hey, hallelujah. I must walk before Him and be holy and be perfect as He has enabled me to. Glory to God. I understand that He died for a cause, although He was hated without cause. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to refresh, glory to God, your memory in the word in 1 Peter 4, glory to God. Hallelujah. He was hated without cause, yet died for a cause. And so you got to see yourself being in the same position He was in. There is great significance to our Yeshua, our Messiah, our HaMashiach, glory to God, our Savior, our Lord. Hallelujah. There was great significance in His life, His birth, His death, His resurrection, glory to God. The Lord, our Yeshua, our Adonai, meaning He is our Lord. Glory to God. He has nothing to do with what we see in this world or what the world would call Easter. Glory to God. And I can remember, hallelujah, coming up as a little girl and we all celebrated Easter. But when I got into the things of God and when I really got into the things of God, I saw myself moving from that place of being like the world, because I just couldn't find the Easter that the world portrayed in the book. I think I only bought my girls maybe 2 Easter dresses out of their life. I think when they got to be maybe 6 and 7, I was over that. I think Dad might have did a little something for them, but honey, I was over Easter egg hunting and all that foolishness. Glory to God. We'll learn later that in the community Seder that I was in on yesterday, we'll learn that the roasted egg was a part of a message, but it wasn't, had nothing to do with Easter. It was just a symbol of something. And so as we continue to celebrate this holy time, this holy week of God, that God has called His church to celebrate those feasts of the tabernacle. Passover is called Pesach. Pesach, glory to God. We must continue to allow our lives to truly be grown up in Him. And so as we learn Him, all about Him and those symbols, glory to God, we will draw nearer and closer to Him. And I can see the church of the living God, the church of the 21st century, really coming into understanding what it means, glory to God, to be hated without cause. What it means to die, glory to God, that Christ died for a cause, and that what we see Him to be is not what it merely is, but there is so much more in learning about our Savior and why He came, glory to God. He rose for a great cause. Say with me, He rose for a great cause. His mission was planned from the very beginning, glory to God. It was. The Bible says He was in Christ, reconciling the world back to Himself. He was from the beginning. It was God from the beginning doing what needs to be done. And so His death was not for naught. And you got to see that. And you can only see that by in your experience, your way of living. You can say Christ died for me, He died, and I received that benefit. But talk, as I always say, it's cheap. You got to experience that through activity, through a lifestyle of walking as his great protege, which means his dependent. I'm reflecting Christ. I'm reflecting the cause that he died to save me, to raise me up, glory to God, to empower me. We are yet, wholeness is God's way. And I want the church to remember that. We are empowered by his spirit and saved by his grace. Remember that. I'm saved by his grace. I'm saved by his favor. And he's always working on my behalf. I don't have to be shut in and shut out of the things of God. I'm saved from that. Christ already died. The work was finished on the cross. When he said it was finished, it was finished. All things that pertain to godliness, that pertain to life, was finished for you. Your blessing, your healing, your deliverance, the very call of God upon your life was finished at the cross. He is not to do anything else for us. Say with me, it's already done. So this morning I want to reflect the scripture. The scripture. Some would say it was Jesus' last seven words or last utterance. But I would say these are the last last seven statements. And we've used this in Christendom, these last seven utterances or statements over the years. But we need to understand the great significance. It's time out for us to talk the talk, and it's time for the church to really prove that Christ died yet for a cause. And we prove that by what? Being it. Being it with great evidence. And so as Christ suffered, we must understand that the scriptures say, therefore, we must suffer. If we don't suffer, we can't what? Reign with him. And so this is the road that the child of God must travel. These seven things. You got to travel this road and be willing to travel it with everything you got. Meaning I'm willing to exhaust myself into what God has said. Therefore, there is no room. There is no time. There is no time for self-preservation and reserving myself and my will. Glory to God. We must understand that Jesus was hated without cause, and so will we. You're not going to be hated by the devil and by those that don't know God until you get this. Mm-hmm. They're not going to hate you. If you ain't feel the hate because of the Bible talks about love those that persecute you and speak all manner of evil against you. But for my sake, rejoice. If you don't know what that is, you haven't gotten there yet. Mm-hmm. And be exceedingly glad. You need to be hated. You need to be persecuted for the cause of Christ. It is going on in our world today. In other countries, many are suffering for the cause of Christ, for the testimony of their faith. They're being beheaded right now. Many are being boiled in hot oil alive, skinned. They have to hide out in caves just to get the gospel. This is what literally hated for the cause really is. We don't understand that. That's why the Bible tells us, he corrects us right away. You have these light afflictions.
That's right.
Our affliction is so light till it's pathetic.
My God.
Yet he died for a cause. Let's go to the book, 1 Peter 4 and 1. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Jesus.
The closer we get to this word and understanding it, the humble we become, and the more broken we become over our own sin, and the more empowered and ignited and zealous we become to allow ourselves to be warmed by the fire of the Holy Ghost. So then, since Christ suffered physical pain, you, see yourself, he's talking to you, must arm yourself with the same attitude he had. Be ready to suffer too. Say with me, be ready to suffer too.
Be ready to suffer too.
Say, Lord, I'm ready to suffer too.
Lord, I'm ready to
suffer too. For you have suffered physically for Christ, you have finished with sin. My I come from Zion. Oh my God, his words like that just take me to another level. You won't spend the rest of your lives chasing your own desires, but you will be anxious to do the will of God. It is receiving words like this that gets us ready for God's great transition. Mary had to prepare. She didn't have to. She was already prepared for the great transition. The birth of baby, that nobody had nothing to do with a man. Folk gonna talk about me, they're gonna ridicule me, they're gonna say, she was sneaking around, she was doing this, and that, and now Joseph's gonna leave me and all that. But her heart was already ready. As you say, Lord, so be it done unto me. So we'll be willing to do, anxious to do the will of God. Third verse. You have had enough in the past of the evil things that godless people enjoy. Their immorality and lust, their feasting and drunkenness and wild parties, and their terrible worship of idols. Of course, your former friends are surprised when you are no longer plunged into the flow of wild and destructive things they do.
Lord God.
See, until your wild party friends begin to hate you, you ain't got that yet.
My God.
You must know the hate from them, because why? You begin to diss them. Oh, you got all brand new on me? Certainly I have. You can come get brand new with me. But if you don't want to come, you're going to hate me while I am. So they slander you. At the end of the fourth verse, say, but remember that they will have God to face, who will judge everyone, both the living and the dead. That is why the good news was preached to those who are now dead. So although they were destined to die like all people, they now live forever with God in the Spirit. Glory to God. And so all this Christ did for you. He is giving us an open and a clear understanding, instruction as to what must take place. Every believer must walk physically out the life of Christ in this earth. Every child of God needs to understand what it means to be hated by their old friends. What it means to be disliked even by those that say they know Christ. For the Bible say he came among his own folk and they received him not. They rejected him. They hated him without cause. Was it not his own that took him to the very grave?
Yes, yes.
Say with me, I need to go to the grave. I need to be hated. I need to be rejected. I need to be looked over and disliked.
Yes.
I need to walk in the room and folks say, do you know how much talk went on about Jesus? If you are carrying his same spirit, if you are filled with the Ruach Kadosh, which is the Holy Spirit, then you suffer chance of the same fate. So these seven things, Christ suffered. Luke 23, go to the book. To let us know that I must be willing to know that he died for a cause. And the cause he died for was to empower me to walk out these things that he walked out. As Christ forgave, number one, so much we be willing to forgive. And those that hated him, those that persecuted him, those that chose flesh, they chose Barabbas over the Holy Savior. We want Barabbas. We want flesh. We want money. We want dope. We want the world. We want the fast life. We want the highway. We want the crowded way. We want to be prestige. We want to be famous. We want to be rich and slim and pretty and beautiful. We want the world. We want the fame of the world. That's what they were crying out. Well, what do you want with Oh, we don't want him. Mm-mm. Crucify him, they said. But yet, and even in all that, when folk are talking about you, when they are crucifying your name and scandalizing who you are, you must have the same heart as Christ had. 34th verse, Luke 23. This is the cause he died for. Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. And the soldier gambled for his clothes by throwing dice. I believe it is in the book of Matthew, around the 6th chapter or the 9th chapter, where the scripture say, if you don't forgive man their transgression against you, your heavenly Father will not forgive you your transgression. So he died for the cause for you to forgive, and not only to forgive, but to be enabled to forget. Amen. If he has thrown our sins in the sea of forgetfulness to remember, no more so can we.
Thank you, Lord.
It is the oil of the Holy Ghost, the anointing that destroys the yoke that calls us to be purified and cleansed. Amen. To the point that we why? Because we've been forgiven.
Yes.
When we don't receive forgiveness from God, we remember.